Hi all, welcome to ESI Cloud Trainings. My name is Shali Nerella. Let's get started with Delbhoomi Atmosphere Basic Training Day 4 session. The agenda planned for today is we'll go through the process lifecycle, the deploy tab, atom management tab, and process reporting tab. We'll trigger a process, we'll schedule a process, and we'll see how licenses are consumed. And with an example, we'll see how we can minimize the licenses. Right? So let's get started. So far when we execute a process, we see that we execute it from here, which means you are executing the process in test mode. But test mode has a limitation that it allows only 100 documents and 10 MB of data. But in real time, you see that thousands of documents, lakhs of documents flowing through, right? In that case, what we'll have to do, we have to deploy the process. We have to deploy the process and execute from there. So deploy page allows you to attach one or more atoms to a specific process and also to deploy your latest revision of process. If you want your process to be available behind the firewall, you'll have to first deploy the process, right? So say now I want to deploy this process, FTP to disk integration. So see here attached environments, they are null. So how I can attach an environment? From here, see here attached environments, zero. Here we have the unattached environment. So what an environment is, so environment gives you greater control over your change management and support different connection configuration using extensions. So say in real time, you'll be having test environment, stage environment, production environment. So there'll be different environments for us. So these environments allow you to have different change management, so you can have different connection configurations across these environments, right? So here, if I have to create this environment, where I can do that? So for creating an environment, I'll go to Atom Management under Manage tab. So go to Atom Management. So in Atom Management, you can review and modify the properties and settings for atoms, molecules, and environments. Right? So see here, this is how the atom management page looks like. So you can first go and create an environment. You can create an atom from here or an environment from here. So you can go and create an environment. When you create an environment, it asks you for the environment classifications, whether it is production environment or test environment. So why we have this classification like this? So production environment consumes production licenses, whereas your test environment consumes test licenses. So the test licenses are usually cheaper than production. And they have certain limitations that like mail notifications cannot be sent. Like this is usually used for your testing purposes, test environments. So now I'll give a name to this environment. I'll say Shalini environment. Usually in real time, we'll be having like your test environment, dev environment, production environment. So you'll have to name with your different environments, right? So I've created one environment with my name. So now if you click on here, you'll be having environment ID, the classification, roles, attachments. So here you see choose atoms to attach. So here it will display all the atoms that are available and you'll have to select one atom. So just by attaching that atom. So this is the atom that I'll have to attach to. So let me delete this. So how I can delete an atom out from the environment? So just by clicking on here. Right, now I have to choose this atom. So that's the reason we need to give meaningful atom names to differentiate. So this is the atom that has been attached to. Okay, so now here we have environment extensions. We'll look into that later, and delete an environment. If you want, you can delete it from here. And if you want to change the environment name, you can change it from here. Right, and now this is the atom that we attached, and atom, you can see the atom information like the atom ID, type atom status online. So if it is offline, it shows you red. So the see here, this is red and which is offline. So which means the atom is not anymore communicating with the data center. So as I told in day one session, the atom sends heartbeat to data center. For every very frequently it sends data, the heartbeat. And if the data center doesn't get the information after certain time, it shows the atom as offline, which means the atom is not sending any data, right? The host name, where it is installed, date installed, extensions last updated, version, RSS monitor feed, RSS alerts only feed. We'll discuss about this detail in later sessions. Clear detailed atom status information, detach from environment, delete atom, restart atom. So if you want to restart your atom, you can restart from here as well, right? Startup properties, atom architecture. So this gives you atom architecture, atom time zone. This is very important, atom time zone, where it is. Maximum RAM available, directory free space. So all related information to atom will be shown up here. The log files, atom logs, AS2 artifacts, MLLP artifacts, shared server logs. So these are different log files. We'll discuss in detail about this in later sessions. Deployed processes. So if you deploy any process, the list will be shown here. So these are the listeners. We'll discuss about all this in detail in later sessions, right? So also we discussed about release control window. Remember in the first class, we discussed about release control window. So every month we'll be having releases, Bhumi releases every month. So you can schedule when you'll want those release controls on, so onto your atom, whether it is never, first week, last week. So like this, you can schedule certain time for your atom to automatically update, right? So now deployed processes are zero here, because now we created an environment. We'll go to deploy tab and we'll attach the environment to the process, attach the atom to the process. So now if I click on day two, you'll see that environment Shalini is created. Attach this environment and say deploy latest revision of processes. So it is always good to give a deployment notes. First deployment. So whenever you modify something and if you're deploying it, it's better to mention the change here. And this is deployed. Say you have modified something in your process, you modified and you want to deploy this back. So you can go here and say deploy latest revision of processes. So you can deploy latest revision of processes. And you see here, you can see different options, redeploy this version. So you can redeploy this version. So now this will create new version as 3 and will have the same components which were there in this deploy, in this version. Compare deployment. You can compare this deployment. So choose a revision. Say in real time what happens, you'll have test environment, and once it is completely tested in test environment, you are moving it to production. So before moving it to production, it's better you compare the versions with the previous deployed version in production to see what changes are done. So now see, this is version 1 I'm comparing with. Right now, because there are no changes, it doesn't show anything. But if there are any changes, they'll be displayed in yellow. If there are any deletions to the components, they are highlighted in orange. Right? So that is about compare deployment. You can copy this deployment. So real time, when you're moving from test to production environment, you usually copy from test environment to production environment. So you'll be saying, you'll be selecting the production environment here and say copy from test environment. It is not a good practice to deploy into production directly from the build page. When you're copying, when you go to production environment and say deploy latest revision, you're not taking it from the test environment. You're directly deploying it from the build page. So the changes, my anyone can add any